and gentlemen, and welcome to A Night on the West End. Tonight you will be taken on a roller coaster ride, experiencing the magic of the West End musical. From Sir Andrew Lloyd Webber's newest musical, Sunset Boulevard, from which we have just heard the song, With One Look, to Victor Hugo's story of life in 19th century France in Les Miserables. We begin this evening of entertainment at Rydell High School, where Greece is the word. This show, presently showing to sell-out audiences at the Dominion Theatre, was conceived by two out-of-work actors at a party in 1970 and has become one of the most popular musicals of all time. This was mainly as a result of its 1978 film version, with the title roles being played by John Travolta and Olivia Newton-John. The story and music is based on people and songs that the writers liked back in the 50s. It's an affectionate musical of life, of college boys and girls, and their personal and ongoing rivalry. But most of all, it's about having fun, something the show still manages to do some 20 years on. We open the show seeing the arrival of the Pink Ladies at Rydell High School for the first day of a new term, and the story of what happened during those summer nights.
What's all the racket out here?
My man is Steve.
like to stand. Some of us like to show off and be scared and pray. Some of us check out this totem out over here. Get lost, Twizzle.
How do you like school so far, Scary?
Oh, it seems wonderful. I was going to go to Immaculata, but my father had a fight with the Mother Superior over my patent leather shoes.
What do you mean?
She said the boys could see off my dress and reflections.
Even if she's like that, Sandy.
1977. A show called Annie opened on New York's Broadway. The show won numerous awards, including 7 Tonys, the Broadway Theatre's highest tribute, including that for Best Musical of the Year. Annie was brought to Britain in 1978. There have been Swedish, Australian, South African, Mexican, and even Japanese Annies, although tonight's will hopefully be in English. We join the orphanage, where the children are suffering yet another night under the watchful eye of their principal, Miss Hannigan.
Thank you.
1983, and it was business as usual on Merseyside. Liverpool were top of the league again, but the word was that Everton could be on the way back. The hottest ticket in town, however, was not for the Derby game, but for a musical called Blood Brothers at the Playhouse. This was the story of twin brothers who grew up on opposite sides of the Liverpudlian social and economic scales, unaware of their kinship until all was revealed when one inadvertently kills the other. In 1984, Blood Brothers closed in Liverpool, and over the following 3 years, built up a successful reputation on tour throughout Great Britain. It was decided that the moment had come to take a chance on a return to the capital. On July the 28th, after two sell-out weeks of previews, Blood Brothers received one of the most extraordinary standing ovations in West End theatrical history. Few other scores have ever attempted to tackle the urban problems of Thatcher's Britain, and any that do will, after Blood Brothers, have a hard act to follow. Having given a twin brother a word of promise, Mrs. Johnston watches her two sons growing up, both of them unaware of their background.
Thank you. shaking and sweating so much I couldn't even breathe. That's all there is to it. Give me tablets.
Is that it then? You're going to stay on them forever?
Linda.
Look, we've managed to sort ourselves out this far. But what's the use if...
No! We've sorted ourselves out. You think I'm really stupid?
What?
I didn't sort anything out. Not a house, not a job, nothing. It used to be the sweets and ciggies you gave me, so I'm not any up. Now it's a house and a job. I didn't sort anything out. You sorted it out. You and Councillor Amy Lyons. Now give me tablets. I need them.
And what about I need? I need you. I love you. But make it not when you've got them inside you. When you take those things in, I can't even see you.
That's why I take them. So I can't give them to you. I'll give.
Girl inside the woman is waiting to get free. She's washed a million dishes. She's always making tea.
Could I talk to Councillor Lyons, please?
It's a girl inside the woman, and the mother she became, and a half-remembered song comes to her lips again.
Eddie, could I talk to you? Yeah, I remember.
The girl would sing the melody, but the mother stands in doubt and wonders what the price would be for letting the young girl out. each other as two new pins. How one was kept and one was given away. How they were born and they died on the self same day.
Tell me.
once in every 5 years or so, given average theatre-going luck, a musical soars out at you across the orchestra to strike you between the eyes as well as the ears. Les Miserables is one such, a great blazing pageant of life and death at the barricades of political and social revolution in Victor Hugo's 19th century France. We opened this show in the factory, where the workers describe their hardship, and where one particular girl recalls happier days before her dreams turn sour. We then see a night in the inn, under the watchful eye of a generous landlord. Finally, the workers rally up the support of others before the battle commences.
Thank you. for the rest, all of the crooks, rooking the guests and cooking the books. Seldom do you see an honest man like me, a gent of good intent, who's content to be the master of the house, keeper of the zoo, ready to relieve them of a soup or two, a walker in the wine, making up the weight, picking up their knickknacks when the cart sits straight. Everybody loves a landlord.
Thank you.
century back to the 20th century and the invention of the electric-powered locomotive that took the place of the steam engine, much to the despair of some. Starlight Express, completed by Sir Andrew Lloyd Webber and Richard Stilgoe in 1983, has been described as the fastest musical on the West End, where it continues to amaze audiences after 11 brilliantly successful years. Ladies and gentlemen, hold on to your seats and join the cast of Starlight Express on their railway roller coaster.
Thank you.
brings you to the end of your journey for the evening. You will notice that many children have played their part in the show, and it is through their hard work, concentration and effort that we find ourselves here tonight. The idea was to involve as many children as possible, and this, as I'm sure you will agree, has been achieved, with over 80 children taking part in one way or another. Could I please ask you to put your hands together once more as I introduce you to the players? Firstly, the cast from that happy orphanage in Annie. Decided to do this, and that's Miss Jo Lawrence, who I certainly couldn't have